first edition of 5 minutes, five questions. My name is Lance Nkwe. I'm corporate marketing manager at Flights in a Travel Group. And I'm honored to have Martin Lydall, chief commercial officer at Europcar. So do you have any great stories around what Europcar has done to help your travelers during this pandemic?
Yeah, I think the lockdown came very suddenly for us. We had the same amount of notices as everybody else. And from full operations, we were down to about nothing. And I think I was really impressed with our team and how it rallied together to sort of close up shop as best as they could. I knew it all along. It's always delightful in hard times just to see how people care for one another. So it was really good to see the Europcar team come together. There were many people stuck all over the country that needed cars and needed to get home. And I saw many examples of people actually just putting people first instead of businesses first, just to make sure that they got into a car and they were able to get back to their loved ones.
What are you guys doing to improve traveler safety and hygiene going forward when renting your cars?
Pretty much like most businesses, we have three different key operations. So we've got our areas, we've got operations and our people. In terms of operations, we're doing pretty much what most people are in terms of regular sanitizing of branches, making sure that you sanitize anything that's touched between every single transaction, proper screening, health checks, support for our staff, isolation procedures, making sure those who work from home do work from home, making sure that old and vulnerable people are not put in harm's way. In our vehicles, though, from our customers' perspective, so we want to make sure that there's no chance of spread of the virus when you come in to transact with us. So through the branches, everything is as clean as possible. Proper social distancing. Every car is sanitized. All hard surfaces are wiped down with a disinfectant, both inside and outside, particularly hard touch points like mirrors, steering wheels, gear levers, handbrakes, door handles. And then at the end of that, we put a steering wheel hanger on it just to evidence that, to check that it has been done properly, but also to give our customers comfort that it has been done. I'm sure you're aware of our world famous mints in our cars. So we have that with every single rental. And for the next couple of months, we're replacing those with hand sanitizer that we'll be giving to our customers as well.
Now that's some really great measures there, Martin. So in terms of the surge in demand, what are you guys anticipating for, when business travel particularly kicks in?
Along with most tourism businesses in South Africa, we're very linked to what happens with the air travel scenario. I think that industry in particular has had an enormous amount of pain. There's still a lot of fear and uncertainty, and there will be a bit of a trickle effect. So the first brave souls will get onto airplanes and fly down to Cape Town and have their business meetings, come back, and they'll be okay, and they'll be able to share with their friends and family what the actual procedures are, whether they have to wear masks, what type of sanitizing you have to do before and after you're on the aircraft. And I think that'll build fast. It's important for people to get out there and do business with the people so that we can get the economy going, and I think that'll build. So as the airlines come back on stream and air travel normalizes, we expect that curve to rise rapidly. So I think it'll be slow to start, but it'll definitely come up fairly quickly.
As you can imagine, a lot of business travelers are going to be probably quite nervous, once travel starts to open up again. What are you guys sort of doing to better assist these people once travel kicks in, just to feel a little bit better about it?
I think in our business, we've always understood that it's important that you get a good deal every time and there's a value in every transaction. But the understanding is that we, what our business is geared to is to try and make travel easy for our travelers, our renters. And so where that starts from when you make the booking, to make sure you can book it in the most easy and efficient way, to when you have a checkout. You're also familiar with our ready service, where we have a gone in 30 seconds promise, where you basically scan your driver's license and give you keys if you're a corporate traveler. And I think we continue to focus on those things. Over and above that, we want to make sure that people understand that our business is a process-driven business and we're good at that. So we have good skills and good controls and good quality measures. And so when we say that we've cleaned the car and the car's been properly serviced and it's roadworthy, we know it is because we've checked and double-checked and quadruple-checked and we have lots of measures to check that. So
the coronavirus obviously has dominated the news for a while now. It'd be good to hear of other unrelated projects, you know, to get business travelers excited about travel again that Europcar is working on?
We are investing in a project that we call customer self-service, which allows customers to pick their own cars, get their keys without interacting with people, but more importantly, deliver that gone in 30 seconds ready service experience that we have with contracted customers to all customers. And so those things are quite challenging in our environment. We're a highly regulated environment. We have high asset risk, and we have other risks with regards to fraud. And so there are a number of things that we have to make sure that we get right. But the technology that's available at the moment is amazing, and we can certainly do very exciting things with customer take-on. So we know exactly who we're dealing with. We can secure methods of payment. We can predetermine the packages that they want in terms of the risk that they want to take when they rent cars with us in terms of waivers. And so that project is already in full swing and making big investments in it, and we're hoping to get it out to the market very quickly. I'm very excited about that. I think when we get that right in South Africa, we won't just be the first company to get it right in South Africa. I think we'll be one of the first companies in the world to get it right.
Thank you so much again, Martin, for making yourself available. And I think, you know, you've really put my mind at ease, you know, around sort of what's happening at Europcar to get us ready for the road once again. Thank you.